This time on Matt's Complete Cook-Up, we've got sausages and mash with delicious onion gravy. For this recipe, you'll need some onions, some potatoes, some good quality sausages because life is too short for bad sausages, and you'll also need some thyme, some beef stock cubes, a bit of corn flour, some milk, and some butter. And making onion gravy is thirsty work, so I'd also recommend pouring yourself a beer, although obviously not like this. Now, first of all, you'll want to cook more onions than you actually need because it'll stop them from getting too dry when they cook. But cooking this many onions will make you cry. But if you put them in the freezer for about 15 to 20 minutes before you chop them up, that should mean a lot less tears. Thinly chop all the onions by hand, or if you're a middle-class wanker like me, use a food processor. People will take the piss out of you, of course, but how quickly can they destroy onions? Melt about 25 to 30 grams of butter in a pan, and then add the onions. Move the onions around on a medium heat until they start to soften, then turn it down a bit and occasionally stir for about 15 to 20 minutes. You don't want the onions to completely caramelize, but you do want them to start going that lovely golden brown. And in between all of that occasional stirring, you'll have been peeling and chopping some potatoes. Whack them into a big pan of salted water and cook for about 20 minutes. But the reason you start on the onions first is because they're not as time sensitive. Once they're done, take them out and put them in a bowl. That's an awful lot of onions, you're thinking. Yes, yes it is. But you don't have to eat them all this time. You can put about half of these in the freezer and the rest will happily serve about 3 or 4 people. Or you can just go mad and eat all of the onions. Give the pan a quick wipe down and then add the sausages. Now, I'm not going to tell you how to cook sausages, but I am going to show you some video footage of sausages cooking while I say the words, sausages. Once the sausages are cooked, add in some of the onions, a bit of thyme, and between 300 and 400 milliliters of stock, depending on how you like your gravy. And just a little bit of corn flour to help thicken it up. And don't overdo it, because the corn flour will take about 5 minutes of cooking to kick in, and then just continue to simmer it all while you wait for the potatoes to finish. The amazing thing about mashed potatoes is you can pretty much add whatever you want. Cheese, mustard, actual pound coins. But here I'm just going for the simple combination of black pepper and hot milk. If you can't be bothered faffing around with another pan, just whack it in the microwave for 30 seconds. But hot milk really does make a big difference. If the gravy isn't thick enough, add more corn flour, or if it's a bit too thick, add a little more stock, and then et voila, you're done. And that's it, sausages and mash. It's basically just a platform for gravy, but that's fine. If you've enjoyed this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'll make a vague effort to do more cooking videos in the future. Goodbye!